Well, you may know that during the Civil War, Maryland was truly a house divided. It was stuck in the middle of the war between the states geographically and economically, loyal to the Union, but slavery was legal.
And there may be no better example of this than at the Battle of Gettysburg. It's 150 years ago
wow.
next week, and it's where, as our guide explained to us, that when it came to soldiers from Maryland, it actually was brother against brother.
Culp's Hill, July 2nd and 3rd, 1863. One of the fiercest battles at Gettysburg, and it was Maryland soldiers fighting Maryland soldiers.
This is kind of where you can see that Civil War is really a war of brother against brother.
Culp's Hill was like the Civil War in miniature. On the Union line, the first Maryland Eastern Shore, the Confederates charging up the hill, the 2nd Maryland Battalion. The flag bearers for each side were cousins, and the Confederates were getting pounded by more Maryland firepower.
Roughly 4:30 in the morning of July the 3rd, Union artillery battery up on Powers Hill, which is about 3/4 mile off in that direction, from Maryland is going to open fire on these Maryland troops. Okay, that artillery barrage will go on for quite some time.
Our battlefield guide, Bob Radke, is also a Marylander.
People are amazed when I tell them that there are Maryland troops fighting Maryland troops here at Gettysburg. They had no idea that Maryland was such a divided state. It was a border state during the Civil War. Abraham Lincoln put Maryland under martial law because he could not afford for Maryland to secede from the Union, otherwise Washington would be completely surrounded by Confederate territory.
The move drove thousands across the Potomac River to Virginia to enlist in the Confederate Army and then return north to fight, often against neighbors, friends, and family. More than 3,000 Marylanders served on both sides at Gettysburg. About 2,000 of them fought on Culp's Hill. The rebels came with 400 men and lost half. The Yankees started 1,500 strong and had 137 casualties.
Here on Culp's Hill, you can also see the remains of a trench that was dug by Union soldiers. At the time, this would have been much higher. They used it to protect themselves from the oncoming rebels. The Union soldiers would have just been shooting right down the hill at the Confederate soldiers who were basically just out in the open. Their only protection were trees.
Also hidden in the landscape, a burial pit. Temporary mass grave for hundreds of Confederate soldiers. Not on the map, need a guide like our Bob. And if you follow his lead, you'll find witness trees too, so named because they observed what happened here 150 years ago.
I can feel myself at times, just the chills are starting to run up my back when I'm explaining how these guys came across the field knowing what was waiting for them on the other side. You know, you got artillery fire coming right at you and you still keep going.
The valor of the troops. Bob Radke says even back then, it seems like the one thing both sides could agree on.
When you think about the duty and the honor these guys felt and what they did here, you can't help but get chills.
I just got chills
that
again
is,
when
that's
he said
really
that.
Amazing.
Can you believe that?
Yeah,
fighting
I know.
Your cousin, your brother?
I can't imagine it. I
Another
really can't.
Interesting thing is there's signs all over the place that say no relic hunting.
Really? Because they're still are there.
Yeah, they still find musket balls and bullets. You're
what if you
to
find
turn
one?
Them You're supposed
oh,
to turn them
oh, you have to turn them back in.
Apparently, they can use them to tell which branch of service may have come through that area. They still use it today to try and map how the battle all played out.
I so kept tell thinking, the story.
I kept thinking I was going to stumble across a musket or something.
But no,
didn't find anything.
What do you think of that, Tom?